We'll just take you somewhere to have a sleep, eh? Because you had a little bit too much today. Watch out. You got anything in them pockets?
For the past 3 years, drinking in public in the Northern Territory has become an increasingly risky business.
It's an unprecedented program we're about to embark on, the first of its kind in Australia. It will be controversial.
This is Saltbush, the low security section of Darwin's old prison. Now home to some of the Territory's problem drinkers. They're here for repeatedly being drunk in public, and for that, they are detained for 3 months.
Get away from all those grogs and whatever, humbugs and all that. You think about yourself.
60-year-old Donald Gunnambar from Arnhem Land was picked up in Darwin after he went on a drinking binge following the death of his wife.
Is there anything you don't like about being in here?
I miss all my family. That's all.
Saltbush is one of two mandatory treatment centres in the Northern Territory.
Yes, it's a loss of liberty, but the decisions that these people make about their, whilst they're at liberty, are so destructive to themselves, their families and the community as a whole, that is really where the focus is and always needs to be.
The minister, who's had to give up his corrections portfolio over the treatment of children in juvenile detention, John Elferink, is still responsible for alcohol mandatory treatment. He spoke to 7:30 before the Four Corners program on youth detention.
We have such a profound alcohol and drug problem, particularly an alcohol problem in the Northern Territory, that it's important that we try everything we possibly can.
Look, it's pretty clear that if you try to compel people who are not ready to undergo some sort of treatment and rehabilitation program, it's not likely to work.
The mandatory treatment centres have always been controversial in the Territory, and the government has struggled to produce evidence to show the $23 million program is making a difference.
It is a very costly system to taxpayers. There is absolutely no evidence base that this is a system that is working.
I was drinking too many drugs, and I couldn't probably think my family and children, my grandchildren.
Do you feel like you couldn't take care of them?
Randall's here. Okay, now to start the machine.
Geoffrey Wilson has paid a personal price for his years of alcohol abuse.
So the handbrake's up.
Although this is his second time in mandatory treatment, he's not confident he will stay off the grog when he's released.
It's a little bit too hard. Can't stop.
A bit hard sometimes. See, when you get out from him, you don't know which direction you're going to go.
You're not allowed to drink here.
I think it does, unfortunately, target Aboriginal people, and the reason for that is those people who do drink tend to do so in public places. The difference with non-Aboriginal people is that a lot of that alcohol consumption goes on at home or behind closed doors.
I don't accept that. I think that this is a genuine attempt to introduce a health response.
Would you just have to add an ES instead of just S?
Yep.
Many people here have gaps in work and education.
Yes.
On top of alcohol addiction, some have chronic health problems too. Others have been victims or perpetrators of domestic violence.
So if you grab round and round like that, see, going round in a circle?
Saltbush is run by a private company owned by Karen Sheldon. With a background in catering and job training, her philosophy here is to try and provide skills for future employment.
You know, we totally believe that a person with a job is a person with a future and a reason to get out of bed every morning. That's the whole mantra of our whole business, really.
So it's double action, okay, there's two.
Karen Sheldon rejects criticism that the rehab program does not work.
We are seeing more and more people at least improving their situation on how they came into the centre. And we always say that we would like to have people back twice, you know, because you can't change a life in 3 months.
Almost a year after Lawrence Gunambar finished his second stretch in mandatory treatment, he's making a voluntary visit back to Saltbush. Before his rehab, he was homeless, living away from his kids, and had recently spent time in jail.
Hello, Nicole.
Hello, Lawrence.
Lost my family for a long time. Maybe for 3 years or 4 years.
Today, he's collecting a work qualification he gained at Saltbush.
Congratulations.
Thank you. I'm happy about this. I'm proud. I'll be getting another job.
So, you got somewhere to live in, can you?
The government has commissioned a report to examine the impact of mandatory treatment, but it won't be finished until after the NT election. In the meantime, the government has drawn up plans to expand mandatory treatment. It's also left the door open to making an escape from mandatory rehab a criminal offence.
We're not putting it back at this stage, but we reserve the right to be able to talk to the community about whether we should or should not have the absconding component put back into it.
I don't understand why governments don't look at more closely at some of the evidence-based approaches that work. The numbers of liquor outlets, extended trading hours and all of those things, and the ready availability of very cheap alcohol all contribute to, you know, alcohol abuse.
After this visit to Darwin, you're going to head back to Elko Island?
Yeah, I've got work to do.
Lawrence Gunambar now lives back in his community where he's working as a trainer for another arm of Karen Sheldon's company. He has a place to live and his family is supporting his changes.
Right now, I feel proud for my community and for myself and for my kids too.
He credits the Saltbush model of treatment with his transformation, but until the government's review is finished, it won't be clear how many others have had the same result.
Sarah Everingham with that report. Young people are shunning